everybody, it's Nathaniel Dodson from tutvid.com, and today we're going to take a look at this really cool trick in Adobe Premiere Pro. In fact, this would work in pretty much any video editor, but it's how to create a seamless loop with your video, and it pretty much works with any video that you want, barring if, I mean, there's some where it's going to be really tough no matter what, but this is a great trick that works all across the board. You could even, in theory, use it in Photoshop to create your own loop from clips. And I've got some examples running here while I'm talking, so hopefully you've seen that. If you do enjoy this tutorial and you think it's worth your while, well, make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel so you never miss any video tutorials in the future. Let's jump into Adobe Premiere Pro now and check this thing out. Now here in Premiere Pro, we've got the UI looking as it often does. I want to go with, maybe I'll go with this time lapse here of the tractor, and it's a very simple shot, static, not really moving. All we have is the sky moving above our little tractor. The idea is going to be create this seamless loop of this video clip. Now, I need to be able to affect the ends, or the ends of my video clip need to match up. So the very first frame kind of needs to match with the very last frame, but the problem is if I go to my last frame, it doesn't look anything like the first frame. So in order to kind of create our own ends that work, let's just move to about the middle of this video here. So I'm moving to about the 3 second mark of my playhead, or my timeline, I should say. I'm adjusting the playhead positioning, and the clip is about 6 seconds long. That's great. I'm going to grab my little razor tool here, and I'm just going to zip the clip like that. Then I'm going to grab my selection arrow, take the first piece of video and drag it to the end. I'll just select both the video clips and pull them back to the beginning of my timeline. So now my very first frame of this new video is going to match exactly with the very last frame. It's going to seamlessly loop. And now the area that doesn't match up, this bit in the middle, see we've got that rough jump, we can now use a cross dissolve and fade that together. So I can come to my effects and you can see I already have it open, but basically it's here under your video transitions, under dissolve, and then we just choose the cross dissolve, drag that and drop it on the cut between the two clips, and just stretch it out. The further you stretch it out, the more seamless your transition is going to be. Let's check it out. But before we do, hit the little plus icon over here, and we're going to add the loop button right here. So I'm just going to drag that and add it to my list of tools, and I'm going to make sure that that is turned on. This way now, as I play through this video clip, it's going to loop my seamless loop. And you can see, it's going to loop, and we're never going to see the end of the clip. See how it's just playing through and playing through and playing through, and you never see where the break in the clip is. So we can use this trick if I just move downstream a little bit here. Or maybe, you know what, we can just straight up delete what we just did. That only took a couple seconds. Let's test it out on another slightly more difficult clip. Let's go with this clip here. This is these clouds moving over the ocean here. So we'll do the same thing. We're at about, what, 11 seconds or so. We'll just cut this kind of somewhere in the middle. It really doesn't matter. You don't need to be too picky. And we'll drag this over. Just flip the, basically we're just flipping the positioning of the two clips. I'm going to drag it back to the beginning. So now our very first frame is going to match the very last frame. Then all we need to do is go drag that cross dissolve into place. And for this one, well, you can see that Premiere Pro is going to trigger an error. You're going to get this error sometimes. Insufficient media. The transition will contain repeated frames. We can hit OK. I don't like that, though. I'm going to delete that. What you want to do, I've found, this is what works best in a situation like this. You literally take one of the two clips. I'm going to take my second clip here and just overlap it, you know, a few seconds, something like that. Now apply a cross dissolve just to one side. See how it's just on one side? And stretch it out for the length of that, the overlap. And really, the transition only lets you go as far as you overlapped. Now, if we play through this, we can see that, well, wait till we get to the cross dissolve here. You can see it looks a little different, but we're definitely going to have a seamless loop. And the way to make this look even better and even less noticeable, it would simply be to take this, if we're not happy with it, select the cross dissolve, right? Click right on the cross dissolve, delete it, and overlap the video clip even more. Therefore, being able to create a larger cross dissolve. The larger the cross dissolve, the more seamless and difficult it's going to be to kind of spot that moment at which the transition is exactly resetting itself. And you'll just create this seamless loop. So we've done that. I want to show you one last little example before we get going. This is the kind of clip that it's very difficult to create a seamless loop of, because we have an object that's moving that is the focal point of the video. Just imagine watching somebody riding a horse down the road and all of a sudden it just, you know, resets. It's never really going to look natural. That being said, let's give it a shot. So I'm going to come over here. I'm going to grab my razor tool. I'm going to snip it. I'm going to move this clip over here. I'm going to drag both these clips back to kind of starting position. I'm going to select my second clip. I'll just overlap this right off the bat a bit. Let's actually go a lot because we're going to need a lot here. Drag a cross dissolve out, place it in there, stretch it out, and let's see what this looks like. So we'll play this, you're going to see kind of no matter how big your cross dissolve is going to be, it's never quite going to look right. Now here, it is going to look like a seamless loop when you get to the end of the video because those frames match up, but the issue is going to be, the issue will end up being when you get to this point where you're creating this cross dissolve, because the camera's moving and you got the subject that's moving, it's going to be very, very difficult to create a seamless loop of something like that. But for an image where you have that static camera, you know, even something like this where you just have these clouds that you want to just create this seamless loop of these storm clouds flowing through, very good clip to create this kind of effect with. It looks really, really cool. That's really it. That's how you create a nice seamless loop in Adobe Premiere Pro. It takes seconds, but when you know that that's the way to do it, make the split in the middle, flip the clips, and apply a cross dissolve, it's such a great little recipe to just pull together that little seamless loop. Great for little animations if you're creating a seamless animation. And take the concept into Photoshop and use Photoshop's timeline editor when you're working with animations or things like that in Photoshop to create just these beautifully perfect seamless loops where people sit there and look at it and they're trying to pick out exactly where the loop restarts. That's how you know you've done a pretty good job. So for creating a seamless loop here in Adobe Premiere Pro, guys, that's it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.